The new 6103-05 Hose and Wiring Retrofit Kit for Polyvance's nitrogen welding systems features a highly improved connector with a metal anti-rotation feature. This feature is designed to prevent the rotation of the connections against each other while the contact pins are engaged. It also helps align the pins prior to pushing the two connector halves together. Notice that once the rotation feature aligns, the connectors easily slip together and are securely fastened by holding the hose and tightening the lock ring. Here are the tools you'll need to replace your old hose and wiring assembly with the new 6103-05. Begin the installation by unplugging the welder and disconnecting the air and nitrogen lines from the back of the welder. Welders with a nitrogen generator will typically only have one airline connection. To release the hoses from the fitting, relieve any pressure in the line, then push the flange on the fitting in. While holding the flange in, pull the hose from the fitting. Next, disconnect the airless welder and the nitrogen welder hose from the front of the welder. Remove them from the holster and set them aside. Unscrew the two screws under the top shelf of the welder that hold the welder onto the cart. Place the welder on a clean work surface and remove the 8 screws securing the lid of the welder. There are 4 on each side. Lift the lid off the welder and prop it up on top of the front and back panels to facilitate disconnecting the holster switch wires. Welders with a generator or manual air-to-nitrogen switching will not have this connection and will be able to simply remove the top. With the top supported, wrap a piece of tape around one of the yellow wires to make it easier to identify when making the connections later on. Take a picture of the connections so you know which connector the taped wire goes to. Use a flat screwdriver to help remove the connectors from the tabs. With the lid removed, take another photo of the control board connections for future reference. Turn the welder on its side to remove the 4 screws holding the circuit board support to the base. Non-digital welders will not have this feature, and all connections can be made without further disassembly. Turn the welder upright and remove the bulkhead fitting nut, taking care not to tear your label like I did. Pull the connector flange and release the hose from the bulkhead fitting, saving the air fitting as you will need this later. Slide the wires from inside the control panel tunnel. On the opposite side, you will need to disconnect the green ground wires from the grounding stud using an 8mm deep socket or a box wrench. Access to the stud is a little tight, and to make it more accessible, you may choose to disconnect the green hoses. Disconnect the remaining wires. Notice the white connector wire goes to the blue wire. You will need to clip one of the zip ties to remove the black wire from the control board. Take care not to damage any wires while cutting the zip tie. Gently pry or wiggle the connector off the control board. Before installing the new fitting, you will need to use a step drill to enlarge the mounting hole to 3/4 inch. Be sure to clear the area behind the hole to avoid damaging the wires or control board. Once the hole is drilled, blow all metal chips out of the welder and off the control board. The control board will be permanently damaged if any chips remain when the control board is powered up. Install the air fitting to the new bulkhead connector hose. Install the O-ring and star washer to the connector before inserting it into the bulkhead. When inserting it into the bulkhead, turn the fitting so the air opening is at the bottom. tighten the nut firmly while holding it from the back. Fish only the hose and the green ground wire back through the tunnel. Push both to the grounding stud side of the support pillar. Place the ring terminal from the bulkhead connector and the wiring harness onto the grounding stud and securely tighten the grounding nut. Using the green tube running from the top of the flow gauge, connect it to the fitting on the bulkhead connector hose. You will need to reroute it to ensure there are no tight bends that could form kinks in the hose later on. Connect the white wire to the blue wire, leaving the wire loose on the outside of the support pillar. Connect the black wire to the control board in the same position as the one removed. Fish a new zip tie through the appropriate holes on the support pillar to make a loop to hold the wires. To make fishing the zip tie easier, bend the end of it forward so it more directly lines up with the holes. When tightening the zip tie, make sure all the wires line up neatly and no wires are excessively tight. Add another zip tie near the front of the welder. Again, make sure everything is neat and nothing gets pulled tight when the zip tie is tightened. Secure the mounting pillar with the four screws. Make sure the screws pass through the holes on the galvanized vent plate. Place the lid back on top of the welder and reconnect the switch wires. Use your photo to confirm the wires are in the right location. Place the lid into its correct position and secure it with the eight remaining screws. Put the welder on the cart. Connect the hoses and the power cord. Use the two long screws to reattach the welder to the cart. Do not make these too tight or you will bend the shelf. They only need to be snug. Connect the new hose assembly. Remove the large nut, stainless steel barrel, welding tip, and heating element from the old handle and install them onto the new handle. Install the new handle onto the hose. When tightening the connection, hold the hose firmly and only tighten the nut. Tighten it firmly. Do not attempt to twist the handle. Once the connection is secure, place the hot air welder in the top holster, then connect the airless welder and place it in the bottom holster. You are now ready to use your improved Polyvance nitrogen plastic welder.